and ABR about this excellent, well organized seminar, conference, and this general assembly. And then to the next year's general assembly, it's going to be in Oulu, in Finland, in Botnian Arctic cross-border region. On behalf of the city of Oulu, I am going to do short, very short presentation from the city of Oulu. The timing is going to be in the week 38, from 20th of September to 22nd September. And you all want to know where is exactly this place. It's quite north. It's 4,000 kilometer flight from here. I did it this week. You can do it. Yes, you can do it. Best possible option is to go first to Helsinki, wherever you are going, coming, then first Helsinki, and then there is 10 to 15 direct flights from Helsinki to Oulu. It's only one hour flight. Not bad. About the city of Oulu, in the northern Scandinavia, it's the largest one. They are not big cities in this part of the Europe, but we can say that Oulu is the largest one in northern Scandinavia. And this is interesting that it's the fastest growing economy in the whole Scandinavia. It depends how you calculate, but anyway, this is how it has been written. Values, courage, fairness, and responsibility. Then, the whole region has this 250,000 people, not much, but still big enough to make a very interesting development in this part of the European Union. Average age is quite low, 37.9. We have a lot of young people living there in our city region. This gives us a huge possibility for development, entrepreneurship, and also international activities. Our university, there is two universities, university and University of Applied Sciences. Total is this 25,000. But interesting number is this third of the whole population has university degrees. And that makes difference. Oulu has an innovation alliance. This is exactly the same idea that Martin also named yesterday, this triple helix. In our case, in Oulu case, this collaboration is doing quite well. There is quite long history about these businesses, public sector and educational institutes, cooperation, and it seems that it's running well. Oulu wants to be a high technology city, and Oulu is one of the first in the world to test this 5G technology and its huge possibilities. As you all know, this 5G will revolutionize the world. Don't ask what details that it has, but anyway, this is going to be the future of the whole world. We have 18,500 high technology places in 250,000 cities. This makes this sector quite efficient and big one. I have to mention this one interesting event for this particularly young entrepreneurs and small companies. There is an event called Polar Air Pitching. Normally pitching has limited time per company, but this event has not. The only limitation is that there is a hole on ice, and this event is in February, and you have to stand there in 1 meter cold water and do the marketing. And as long as you can do it, so it's up to you. So that's the limit. Then in this picture you can see that Oulu has more than 20 different kinds of research and development environments and test laboratories where companies can test their products. That this kind of system has been very very effective, and the city of Oulu has supported that development. But on the other hand, there is also culture in the city. For example, most northern full-size symphony orchestra in the world is located in Oulu. And then interesting cultural competition, this Air Guitar World Championship. It's globally known, and it's growing and growing all the time. And this is Oulu has that World Championship every year. Here is the picture from our nature. I forgot to mention, you are interested to know what temperature we have next September there. Good news is that there is plus degrees. Today there is minus one or two. Not bad, because every winter we have days over 30 degrees minus. So, but not too many weeks anyway. Per not in September. There is it's like maybe plus 15. It's late summer in the city, the neighborhood. But in the end, once again, on behalf of Botnian Arc and City of Oulu, I warmly welcome you to Oulu next General Assembly 2018. I would like to ask Natalie to come here for this 1 minute closing, but even less. But we know that Natalie wanted to react to the people-to-people issue, and I think it's a very good chance. And I think also it's an honor for us that you share with us the informal closing of the event. So please.
Okay, so this was not planned, so I have to improvise a little bit. Thank you, Martin, for the opportunity. I just wanted to say a couple of things after the panel on small projects. First, this ESPON study that Pavel mentioned again, that was presented yesterday, I don't think you should read it as if they are proposing to replace Interreg. The whole point of that study is to say territorial cooperation matters, and territorial cooperation is bigger than cross-border cooperation. And actually what the study says is that we're facing as Europe several key challenges, and we can only meet those challenges if we work with each other. I think that's all it says. It doesn't try to replace Interreg, so please don't go into panic mode that there is a hidden agenda and that we have commissioned ESPON to kill Interreg. It's not the case. I think it says beyond Interreg, we also need to use the other programs of the European Union to cooperate more than we do right now. That's one thing. The second thing is on the small project fund. I really want once and for all to clarify that we are not against, we've never been, and we are not against small projects. We are very much in favor of projects like that because they build trust. And for those of you who remember our birthday cake, when we turned 25, the bottom layer of the cake on which everything rests is trust. So we are completely with you on that, completely and totally. All the programs can have small project funds. All of them. Those who don't, it's because they chose not to. There is nothing preventing any program from having small project funds. Plus, I would like to say the rules of small project funds are not designed in the European law. They come from the different programs. And I know in some programs it's unacceptably heavy to apply for a small project, but it doesn't have to be like that. I really want to clarify that. It does not have to be like that. And I think the gentleman from mentioned that in his region it's actually an easier, or you can go to the Dutch-German border, they have also lighter rules. And I want to finish by saying that we all talk about trust across the borders all the time, yes. But I also think that we need trust on each side of the border between the institutions, because I often feel that there is also a lack of trust between the local level and the regional level and the national level. And we need to all build also that trust. It's not only about trusting your neighbors, it's also about trusting your partners on your own side of the border, and trusting beneficiaries that they will do a good job, trusting the managing authority that they will look after your interests, trusting the state that they will actually listen to you if you make your case. We really need to do that. If we build our own relationships on mistrust, how can we then build trust across the border? That's what I wanted to say. And thank you for this conference and for the invitation. Looking forward to meeting you.
Thank you, Natalie. Well, it's the time to go closing. So before giving the floor for the really last word to the representatives of Extremadura, I would like to take the chance to thank my region for all their commitment to organize all these events since Monday to today. All those who were in the panel in the morning for the circular economy, a lot of inspiration for many of us. I would like to thank also this panel, a completely different panel to any type of panels we have ever organized in the ABR, but I think it was important to know about the external borders a little bit, to know about the experience that these guys in the Harald, that you are keeping relationship with Russia in very, very time of difficulties. I think it's very relevant. Thank you, Nacho, for reminding us that we are not the center of the world, and probably we have a lot to learn from others. In fact, on Monday we had an activity on cross-border cooperation in Latin America in Cáceres, and that's why today I wanted to give the floor for the last intervention to Ambassador Aguibudiarra, who has developed an extraordinary experience in Africa and the real difficulties. Do you think you have difficulties, guys? Talk to him, and you know what he's been doing difficult things. Also, thank you very much to Pamela. Sometimes we have to put bad news on table, but you know that we are committed to support, and you know my mantra. I would not believe that Brexit will happen until it happens. So maybe something, who knows? And also thank you to Fulga, a very recent member, also to talk about the external borders. Thanks a lot to Mr. Kulik, our Vice President, for sharing this new, brand new panel. And I think we have to think on being to extend the scope of the ABR, because in fact, the scope of cross-border cooperation is extended. Thanks to everyone. Have a nice trip home. And now I will give the floor to Rosa for the last words. Thanks a lot.
Buenos días, buenas tardes. Voy a ser ya muy, muy, muy breve porque hemos escuchado a lo largo de estos dos días grandes intervenciones, ideas y propuestas para el futuro. Con lo cual voy a empezar por los agradecimientos, agradecerles a todos y cada uno de ustedes que desde los distintos lugares que nos acompañan hayan llegado hasta aquí, hasta nuestra preciosa región, hasta Extremadura. Y espero de verdad que hayan disfrutado de estos días. Algunos empezaron con nosotros el miércoles, otros se incorporaron ayer, pero igualmente deseo que lo hayan aprovechado. Agradecer a todas las personas que han colaborado para que esta sea una realidad. A los intérpretes que siempre desde esos cristales que hacen sombra permiten que nuestras ideas lleguen a todos los lugares y que todos nos entendamos. Mi agradecimiento sincero a todos los ponentes. Agradecimiento a Nacho Sánchez Amor, que fue además mi primer jefe, con lo cual es una cosa que me encanta siempre decir y que me hace realmente ilusión encontrármelo en cualquier lugar de España y de Europa cuando coincidimos. Al presidente Lambert por su extraordinaria amabilidad y disponibilidad siempre de estar con nosotros el día de ayer, de esta mañana, sacarle de una reunión para meterle en otra reunión que le hemos podido trasladar. Todas las actividades que hemos hecho en Extremadura, tras recibir el año pasado el Premio Región Emprendedora Europea, se lo hemos podido describir a lo largo de esta mañana. Y trasladarle al compañero, a Heikki, que el año que viene tendrá sus días en Luque, que le espera un año intenso de trabajo, de preparativos, pero que realmente es emocionante, ilusionante el tener la oportunidad que tu región, que tu territorio se convierta durante unos días en el centro europeo de la cooperación transfronteriza. Así que sin más, darles nuevamente de corazón las gracias y desearles que tengan un buen viaje de vuelta a sus territorios y sobre todo que nos lleven siempre en el corazón, porque nosotros así lo haremos. Muchísimas gracias. A los intérpretes le he dado las gracias porque dice Martín que no, para el equipo, lo hice ayer, pero lo repito por supuesto que sí, el agradecimiento al equipo del Gabinete de Iniciativa Transfronteriza de la Dirección General de Acción Exterior, que lo hice ayer, pero lo repito nuevamente, y al equipo extraordinario de la ARFO, empezando por Martín, porque sin Martín nada de esto hubiera sido posible. Muchísimas gracias.